children's ministries from Freedom Church. Welcome all students from the school, all students from the church, all parents, and anybody else who's viewing. Welcome. We have a 10-second counter here on deck. It's going to enable you to get something to drink, something to eat, and give you a chance to do a bathroom run. And get maybe even get some wiggles out like me while I'm waiting on you. Okay, so here we go. What you needed so that you can focus in on God, okay? And right now we're about to do a worship song. We're about to listen to that and maybe dance at home a little bit, you know? But that's going to help prepare our heart, our minds, our spirit, and our soul to just receive God's word and what he has for us today during our lesson as we learn together about more about Jesus, okay? So here we go.
Lord of all creation, of water, earth, and sky, the heavens are your tabernacle, glory to the Lord on high, God of wonders beyond.
give some glory and some honor and some worship and praise to God today because he is worthy. But next up is, hey, do you even know what you're watching? Hello? On the count of three, if you know that you know that you know, let's do this together, okay? One, two, three. All right. If you didn't give your best, or you just wasn't ready, or maybe you just didn't even know, hey, let's do this again. One, two, three. All right. Breathe. Okay. No passing out on me. All right. But next up, because we gotta move on, we can't stay here roaring all day long, although it would be cool. Anyways, let's move on, all right? So bow your heads, we open in prayer, and close your eyes, because we gotta talk to God, all right, right, right? So Heavenly Father, through Jesus Christ, your Son, and by the Holy Spirit, we come to you in prayer. That's the only way. Lord, help us to accept your challenge to think about any sinful thoughts, actions, or words we have been struggling with, okay? And encourage us to pray for your forgiveness and your help to be obedient. Open our hearts and our minds to learn your word and what the Bible says about the curse of sin. Teach us what you want us to know about the declaration of our faith. And everybody at home said amen. And everybody at this home said amen. All right, so let it be so. Today's topic is about the curse of sin. It's coming out of the series, I believe, which is 23 lessons long. But we're getting her done, baby. We're learning more about Jesus together. All right. Today's discipleship lesson is the seventh. Give me seven and a fingers in the air like you just don't care. Okay, and it's the seventh of the I Believe series, which is based on declaring my faith. So say my faith, because it's my faith. And someday, it's guaranteed, okay, that you are going to have to share your faith, because somebody is going to ask you, what do you believe about this, that, and the other, okay? And so you will be able to answer if you are following along closely and listening and just absorbing like sponges these lessons, okay? So this lesson is focusing on the curse of sin. Let's stick to the topic, okay, baby? And today's lesson, we learn about the following doctrines. What is sin? How does sin enter the world? Who tempted Adam and Eve to sin, okay? How did Adam and Eve's disobedience affect you and me? Oh my goodness. Because you have sinned, what do you deserve, or what do we deserve, okay? So those are the following doctrines we are learning about in today's lesson. But before we do all that, okay, we got a game to play, all right? And it is called tic-tac-toe, and hopefully you know all the rules, okay? But players, gonna have to be me versus you, okay? And since you is at home, I need some volunteers, but anyhow, let's find some volunteers, some lovely volunteers. My first volunteer is going to be, ladies first, of course, is Miss Barbie, all right? And give it up for Miss Barbie, because she was baptized not too long ago, and praise God, hallelujah. But she's going to play with me today, and I will play with the letter O, and she's representing you at home, because you can't be here, but in-person services, hello, you can be here, and you can play, okay, and we'll play against each other a couple rounds. But anyway, she's standing in for you right now as a substitute player, and she's going to play with the letter X, okay, and so, I'm gonna go first, okay? And you know, I know it says you, but anyways, I'm gonna go first. And so let's play our first round, all right, of tic-tac-toe together, all right? So my first round, let's see, where am I going to put my O? Okay, oh, wait. I changed my mind. Let's have Miss Barbie go first, okay? Let's have Miss Barbie go first, and she gonna put her ex. Where's she gonna put it? I don't even know. She's just gonna put it. Okay, is that where she's wanting to put it? Good. All right, that's where she's going. All right, so now it's my turn. Okay, if you know how to play tic-tac-toe, you know it's my turn. So let me see. I'm just gonna go boom like that. Okay, and you know. All right. Look, I won. Hey. Woo! Yeah. All right. What was that you said? You say something? Okay. All right. So, yeah. Okay. All right. You want me to start a new game? All right. All right. So, I'm going to challenge you again. And since, you know, some of you as girls and some of you as boys, Mr. Ken has, decided that he would help us out. Let me reset our game board, okay? Because y'all had an issue with that one. And so, hey, I'm going to start over, okay? And, again, we'll just let Ken go first, all right? Since he has volunteered to be a substitute for you, all right? So here we go. Let me just let Ken go first. And he's going to decide, to put his ex right there, okay? And so, let's see. Where should I put my O? Why don't I just go like, you know, boom. There we go. Look, I won again. Oh my goodness, I saw sliding. Oh, about to give me a happy dance on you. But yeah, isn't that cool how you just won two in a row? That's just awesome. What was that you said? You saw something? What? It's not fair. It's not right. I'm breaking rules. What? I don't understand. Okay, all right. Let's we'll just go on, okay? So hey, game over. Hey. What you was trying to tell me there was something wrong with the first way I was playing, you know, this way I was playing this game and stuff, you know, called tic-tac-toe and stuff. I was breaking the rules. This is what you said, all right? And if you said that, you are correct, because guess what? I was not playing fair, and I was cheating. Oh, left and right. Oh my goodness, was I cheating. And once the rules was broken, the game no longer worked, okay? And just as games have rules to play by, so does life. Life has rules to live by, though. And God is the one who makes the rules, which we find in the Bible. He gave us. And if you don't have one, I'm going to get you one, okay? I'm just going to get you one. So the book he gave us, the Bible, that's where God's rules are that he made for us, okay? And when we obey God's rules, our life, it just makes sense, okay? It just makes sense. And disobeying God's rules is called sin. And it just totally messes up our lives, mine and yours, okay? So we've got another thing that we can do here, another activity, and that is, it's tic-tac-toe again. The whole theme of today's lesson is going, in the background, is going to be tic-tac-toe. Okay, but this one is called Create Scripture, Tic-Tac-Toe, right? And here are the directions. We're going to read Scripture. We're going to draw what is described and where it's specified. All right, and we're going to learn the meaning, but I need some volunteers because there are 9 moves. And you know what? Since I don't have no volunteers here at my house, okay? In person, we will have some volunteers. But for now, I've already done it. You know, what I'm going to ask you to do is the drawing part. So I've already done it. So just sit back and relax and just listen closely, okay? But in person, you're going to have to do something, all right? You're just going to have to do something. But let's go on. Our first move is, and we're playing with the same board that we played here. It's just not going to have the X and O's on. We're going to start with that. All right, I'm going to have you have a marker. But for the first move, let's get started, okay? I'm going to read to you. You're going to listen. In Genesis, the Bible says, in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth, okay? And so I want you to draw a circle in the upper left square, okay? And this circle represents the earth, all right? God made it perfectly with no pollution, no hatred, no war, no death. God made the earth out of nothing, okay? And then God filled the earth with nights, days, plant life, animals, birds, oceans, sea life. And God said it was good, okay? All right, so move number two. I'm going to read to you. Listen up here. Okay, so Genesis in the Bible says, then the Lord God formed the man out of the dust from the ground and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life. And the man became a living creature like me and you. Okay. All right. And so I need you to draw a circle in the upper middle square and then make a man's face inside that circle. All right. And this represents Adam, the first man. How did God make the first man, Adam? God formed him from the soil. How did Adam come alive, you may ask? Okay, good. I got an answer for you. God breathed life into him, okay? God did not give life to animals in this way. Instead, he simply spoke them into being. God made man differently because humans are special. The Bible says in Genesis that God made man in his own image, all right? Move number three, listening closely, because I got something to tell you. The Bible says, so the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall upon the man. And while he slept, took one of his ribs and closed up its place with flesh. And the rib that the Lord God had taken from the man, he made into a woman and brought her to the man. All right. And so I need you to draw a circle in the upper right square. And in that circle, a woman's face. Okay. All right. This represents Eve, the first woman. How was she created, you ask? I'm so glad you asked. Because I need to tell you, okay? It's just bursting forth. God took a rib from Adam and miraculously created woman from that rib, okay? And after Adam and Eve were created, God looked at his creation and called it very good. Move number four, reading, listening. The Lord God took the man and put him in the Garden of Eden to work it and keep it. And the Lord God commanded the man, saying, You may surely eat of every tree of the garden. Okay, probably lots and lots of trees, okay? But of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, you shall not eat, okay? For in the day that you eat of it, says God, you, Adam, shall surely die. All right. So for that one, I need you to draw a circle in the left square on the right row and place fruit in the circle and then make a tree trunk at the bottom. All right. Just like that. This represents the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. And where did Adam and Eve live? You guessed it, in the beautiful Garden of Eden. Move number, this is still four, I'm sorry. Adam and Eve lived in paradise, okay? It was paradise. There was no sickness, not even a runny nose or a cough. There was no pains, ouch, ooch, bruise, or bruises. Ooh, ah, ooh, you know, nothing like that. They lived with all kinds of animals, yet they were completely safe. Even lions, you know, just they were safe, okay, completely safe. The temperature, it was never too hot. It was never too cold. It was always just right, baby. What important rule did God give Adam and Eve to live by? Anybody? They must never eat from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. What would happen, you say, if they did eat from that tree, even though God said not to? God said they would die. Okay, now we're on five, all right, of the scripture tic-tac-toe. And I'm going to read, you're going to listen. Genesis. Now the serpent was more crafty than any other beast of the field that the Lord God had made. And he said to the woman, did God actually say you shall not eat of any tree in the garden? And the woman said to the serpent, we may eat of the tree of the, we may eat of the fruit of the trees in the garden, but God said you shall not eat of the fruit of the tree that is in the midst of the garden, neither shall you touch it, lest you die. But the serpent said to the woman, you will not surely die, for God knows when you eat of it, your eyes will be opened, and you will be like God. All right, this is what the serpent was saying, all right? And you will know good and evil. That's a lot for a serpent to say, I'm just saying. But anyhow, what I need you to do is to draw two circles side by side in the right square, and you'll see that in a minute, on the second row and make them look like eyeballs, okay? All right, and this represents opened eyes. God did not create an evil serpent. Instead, the devil became, and here's the eyeballs, okay, the devil became like a snake to tempt Adam and Eve. Remember, people, they were at peace with all animals, including snakes. So Eve was not afraid, whatever, you know, she was not afraid of it, all right? And the devil had once been one of God's angels, but he had turned against God, all right? The serpent told Eve if she ate from the tree of knowledge, her eyes would be opened. In other words, she would be wiser than God and more like him, okay? And Satan's temptation made the fruit look desirable, you know, to Eve. And so that's why we have the eyeballs there representing it. Move six. Genesis, to the woman he said, this is what the Bible said, and a certain said, I'm sorry, back it up. To the woman he said, I will surely multiply your pain, in childbearing, in pain you shall bring forth children. Oh, your desire shall be contrary to your husband, but he shall rule over you. And to Adam, he said, this is what God said, because you have listened to the voice of your wife and have eaten of the tree of which I commanded you, you shall not eat of it. Cursed is the ground because of you. In pain, you shall eat of it all the days of your life. Thorns and thistles shall bring forth for you, and you shall eat the plants of the field. By the sweat of your face you shall eat bread till you return to the ground, for out of it you were taken, for you are dust, and to dust you shall return. So for that, we are going to draw an X in the center square, and this represents two lines crossing each other, okay, as we see right there. And Eve, she had tasted the fruit. She convinced Adam to taste it too. Then they both realized they had done something terrible. They had broken God's rule, and sin had come into the world. Adam and Eve had crossed over God's warnings. And God told Adam and Eve that their lives would become very difficult and that one day they would die, just like he had warned them. Move 7. This is getting intense, okay? I'm about to say, okay, I got to stop and say that. But anyways, we're moving on. Genesis says in the Bible, "Then the Lord God said, behold, the man has become like one of us in knowing good and evil," okay? "Now, lest he reach out his hand and take also of the tree of life and eat and live forever. Therefore, the Lord God sent him out from the Garden of Eden to work the ground from which he was taken. He drove out the man, and at the east of the Garden of Eden, he placed a cherubim and a flaming sword that turned it every way to guard the way to the tree of life." Now, that's a cool sword, I'm just saying, gotta say. But anyways, we're going to draw an X, okay, in the middle square of the bottom row. And this represents exit, which tells us that Adam and Eve had to exit Eden, and God put an angel with a sword in front of the garden to keep Adam and Eve away. Okay, God still, he still loved them. He did. He still loved them. He still does, okay? But they would have to live the rest of their lives with the bad things sin brought into the world. Like, for instance, pain, hunger, fear, sadness, sickness, and death. And I'm going to say that again, okay? Their sin brought into the world pain, hunger, fear, sadness, sickness, and death, okay? And these things we experience now, even today, in our life and in our world. And so we know where they came from the sin of Adam and Eve that brought them here, okay? Move 8. Listen, I'm gonna read. Genesis. Now Adam knew Eve, his wife, and she conceived and bore Cain, saying, "I have gotten a man with the help of the Lord." And so for that one, we are going to draw a circle in the bottom left square and make a serious man's face, okay? And this represents Cain. Cain was Adam and Eve's first son. Move 9, and in closing, boom, somebody shut that door, all right? Genesis says, and again, she bore his brother Abel. Now, Abel was a keeper of sheep and Cain a worker of the ground, all right? And so we're going to draw a circle. We're going to draw a circle in the bottom right square, making a smiling man's face, okay, just like that. And this represents Abel. Cain was a farmer, Abel was a shepherd. Cain let sin take charge of his life, and something terrible happened. The Bible says in Genesis, "Now Cain talked with Abel, his brother, and it came to pass when they were in the field that Cain rose up against his brother Abel and killed him." So we're going to draw an X over Abel's face because that represents Cain murdered his brother. Sin, we just gotta say it, is a terrible tragedy. All right, now that we are finished with the lesson, let's focus in on God and the words to the following video. And that's a form of worshiping when we're listening, okay? And so we need to just give honor to God and listen to what's coming up and just love on him a little bit, okay? So here we go. Mm-hmm.
of many children working his land, his crops and his vineyard, close to his brother Abel the younger, a tender of sheep from the flocks he had gathered. They both worshipped the Lord with the portions they would bring. Cain brought fruit from the land, his choice for an offering. But Abel knew the cost, slays a firstborn from his flock, so found favor with God, but his brother did not. Downcast, Cain was downcast, angry at the Lord, offended and sore, he became downcast. God speaks, Cain hears God speak, just do what is right, so bring me the light. But at your door lies sin, refuse to let it in. Let us walk together, follow me into the field. So much to be seen, but there he struck him down. Abel's blood stained the ground, now there's blood on his hands. Cain has slain another man. Growing darkness in his heart, tries to hide it from the Lord. No repentance, just pretense, sinking deeper into sin. Then it came the dreaded question, deep to his conscience, how could he answer? Where is Abel, your brother? Downcast, angry and downcast, I don't know he will answer. Am I my brother's keeper? So angry and downcast. God speaks, painfully God speaks. What is this you've done? His blood cries from the ground. Now you will be cursed, a restless wanderer.
Sincerity, we believe in our heart and our mind what we are praying, then and we believe on Jesus, we will receive forgiveness from our sins from God the Father and get right with him. Okay, so that's the goal. We need to get right with God, okay, through Jesus Christ. So let's read this together or pray this together to God. Dear God, I know I'm a sinner and I ask for your forgiveness. I believe Jesus Christ is the Son of God. I believe that Jesus died for my sin and I believe that you raised Jesus to life. I want to trust Jesus as my Savior and I want to follow Jesus as Lord from this day forward. Lord, guide my life and help me to do your will. And I pray all of this in the name of Jesus. And everybody at home said amen, and everybody here said amen. So if you said that prayer, hey, you have entered into a right relationship with God, believing in your heart on Jesus, you receive forgiveness from sin, and you are restored with a right relationship with God the Father through Jesus. But you can't stop there, okay? You need to grow and read, pray, worship, get into a Bible-believing, God-fearing, Spirit-filled church, and just worship and serve, okay? And you will notice that you are just growing stronger and stronger in your relationship with God. All right, so that's my recommendation. Answers and questions. This is a review of today's lesson. It's going to be up on our Ward Children's Ministries Facebook page. And if you're coming to the in-person services, you will get the answers and the questions in your activity bags. Okay? This is experience. It's supposed to say tic-tac, no, because when you play this game at home, or in person if we have time, then as you're playing, you will get to know more and more, okay, about Jesus and things, okay, and the Bible and what it says. And so these are just two slides of that explaining it. Testimonies, prayer requests, and needs, if you have them, get them to us, okay, and we'll join you in those things, celebrating and praying and helping meet your needs. You're not alone, okay? Bow your heads, close your eyes. We are closing this lesson in prayer. It was a rough one, I'm just going to say it, but hey, we got through it together. Heavenly Father, through Jesus Christ, your Son, and by the Holy Spirit, we come to you in prayer. Thank you, Lord, for helping us to accept your challenge to think about any sinful thoughts, actions, or words we have been struggling with, and for encouraging us to pray for your forgiveness and your help to be obedient. Thank you for opening our hearts and our minds to learn your word and what the Bible says about the curse of sin. Thank you for teaching us what you want us to know about the declaration of our faith. And everybody at home said amen, and everybody here said amen. Praise God. He is our help. All right. So till next time, know, okay, just know it, all right, that I love and I miss you and that I hope to see you soon in person and live, okay? And so stay healthy and safe and strong until then. Remember to read, pray, worship, serve. Also, you did a breathtaking job learning today. And so here's a little something to shuffle your feet to that hopefully will help you march victoriously for the Lord Jesus. And everybody got some more blue virtual stamps there with a little sheepy on it. But till next time, I love you.